In the Danish folklore, there is a myth about why and how Dannevirke was built. Somewhere in the middle of the 9th century, Otto the Great, who was the king of East Francia, wanted to get the Danes under his thumb so he could collect taxes from them. So Otto the Great traveled to Jelling in Denmark, where King Gorm the Old and his wife, Queen Thyra, lived. Upon arriving, he saw the beautiful Thyra and immediately fell in love with her. So King Otto told King Gorm that he wanted all the gold in his kingdom, including his wife Thyra. And if he refused to follow his command, he will take it by force anyway. King Gorm, who was stupid and lazy, sat on his throne and looked at him while he was picking his nose with his mouth open with a blank stare. And he could only manage to mumble for a bit for himself, because he was too stupid to think of an answer. But then the smart and beautiful Queen Thyra stepped forward and bowed before King Otto and said, "Of course, we will do as you please. You shall have all the gold in our kingdom, and of course, you shall have me as well. We are, after all, just a small kingdom, and you have such a big and mighty empire. My king, if you give me just 1 year, I will personally, together with my close and trusted guards, travel around the whole kingdom and collect all the gold and silver for you. When you come back here the next year on the same date, all the gold and silver will be packed and ready for you to transport back with you, and of course I will travel with you back to East Francia and become your queen." King Otto scratched himself on the back of the head and thought about it for a minute and said, "Yes, that sounds like a good idea. And I don't even have to travel around your kingdom myself. Okay, Thyra, I will be back in exactly 1 year." The next day, Queen Thyra began to travel around the kingdom and collected all the silver and gold. But instead of collecting it for King Otto the Great, she used it to build a wall called Dannevirke, which would function as a defensive position against the south. 1 year later, King Otto returned, expecting to get all the gold, including Thyra. But he was stopped in his track by the massive wall. With Queen Thyra and all her warriors standing on top of the wall, laughing and pointing fingers, and probably making chicken noises at King Otto and his men. This is, of course, a wonderful story, but it is unfortunately just a story. Dannevirke was not built in only 1 year. It was built in sections over hundreds of years, from around the 6th century to sometime in the 12th century. It does, however, seem that it was during the Viking Age that Dannevirke saw its biggest improvements. The Danes has for hundreds of years been under attack from other empires and clans from the south, which is why they decided to build a wall, to function as a defensive position against southern aggression. After the death of King Gorm the Old and his wife Thyra, his son Harald Gormson, also nicknamed Harald Bluetooth, took over the role as king. It was at a time where political tensions were brewing beyond the Danish borders, especially from the ever-expanding Holy Roman Empire, pushing east and north. While Harald's father was having trouble with Otto the Great, now it was Harald's turn to face his son, Otto the Second, also known as the Red. In the 960s, Harald Bluetooth gave the orders to his men to expand Dannevirke. He emptied his chests, collected taxes across Denmark, and gathered every able-bodied person he could from every farm and house to conduct this massive construction of Dannevirke. Trees were cut down, stones were moved, and earth were shoveled. And by doing this, a finger was drawn in the Danish soil. "You can come here, but not further." Dannevirke would become the biggest line of defense in the Viking Age in Northern Europe. Only built with muscles, determination, and a will to survive and protect your families. Dannevirke was expanded to around 5 meters tall which is about 16 feet, 20 meter wide, which is about 65 feet, and about 30 kilometers in length, which is 24 miles. But it was not just one long wall, it was multiple walls, with the longest one being Dannevirke, and the second longest Kovirke. The walls stretched across the neck of Jutland, and the only entrance was at Hervein, which means the army road, where there were a big gate. But Dannevirke was probably not just built as a defensive wall to protect Denmark, but might also have been to protect its trade routes. For instance, the town Hedeby was very close to the wall and therefore close to the southern border. Dannevirke was not built exactly on the Danish border, which would have been the river Eider. Some sources claim that Dannevirke stretched across the whole neck of Jutland, from ocean to ocean, but that is a false claim. In reality, Dannevirke was from the fjord at Sillen in the east to the river Trenen in the west. Further south from Dannevirke was Kovirke, which was an alternative defensive position. It was not necessary to build it from ocean to ocean, because there were huge areas with impassable marshlands and dense forests that protected Denmark from invasions. The Danes would not just stand on the wall and point their spears south in expectation that the Germans would pick a fight with them. After Harald Bluetooth became the King of Norway in 1970, he had increased his power and was no longer willing to accept any orders from the Holy Roman Empire. In the summer of 974, Harald pushed the hand of the emperor away and moved his forces into what today is northern Germany, with the support from the Norwegian Vikings. They defeated the Holy Roman Empire's forces that were stationed there and pushed the rest of them south. When the Norwegians sailed back to Norway in autumn, the Holy Roman Empire's forces attacked Dannevirke and defeated the Danes and pushed far into Denmark. And Harald Bluetooth was exiled to Norway by Otto the Second. The Danes would eventually regain their land, but that is for another video, since this one is about Dannevirke. Dannevirke would be maintained and built upon until the 12th century, where Valdemar the First of Denmark would be the last king to contribute to the development of Dannevirke. Dannevirke would not see its use again before the 18th century, when the Danes yet again was at war with the German war machine in the Slesvig Wars. But even though Thyra was not the founder of Dannevirke, she still was a strong queen that gave courage to the people in difficult times. She was the wife of the first most known king in a long line of kings in Denmark, which makes her the mother of Danish kings. But could there be some truth to the story, and did she somehow contribute to the construction of Dannevirke before her death? That is unfortunately not something we can prove, since there are no written sources from this time period that confirms that this was the case. Today, many people are working on getting Dannevirke recognized as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Although Dannevirke is today located in Germany, I still want more people to know about it, since it is important to know your roots and history. Dannevirke can still be seen with the naked eye in the landscape, although it is not as epic as it would have looked 1,000 years ago. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please give me a thumbs up. If you are new to this channel or have watched a few videos already, don't forget to press that subscribe button for more videos like this. See you next Sunday for another video. Thank you for watching.